वेलकम बैक टू अवर सिक्स स्टैंडर्ड बायोलॉजी क्लास माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी कंप्लीटेड ह्यूमन बॉडी एंड इट्स मूवमेंट, जॉइंट्स एंड टाइप्स ऑफ जॉइंट्स. टुडे इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट ह्यूमन स्केलेटन. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, नेक्स्ट लेट अस लर्न ह्यूमन स्केलेटन्स. लुक एट द पिक्चर. Human skeleton is the internal framework of the human body. The human skeleton is composed of around 305 bones at birth. The number of bones in the skeleton changes with age. It decreases to 206 bones by adulthood after some bones have fused together. Human skeleton performs six major functions. First one, support. Second one, movement. Third one, protection. Fourth one, production of blood cells. Fifth one, storage of minerals. And sixth one, endocrine regulation. Next, let us learn the bones of the hand. Look at the picture. This is the bones of the hand. Your wrist is made up of many small bones and joints. Small bones is called corpuscles that allow your hand to move in several directions. It also includes the end of the arm bones. Next, let us learn the rib cage. Look at the picture. This is a rib cage. The structure of curved bones, ribs, that surrounds and protects the chest. The rib cage surrounds the lungs and the heart, serving as an important means of bony protection for these vital organs. In total, rib cage consists of the 12 thoracic vertebrae and the 24 ribs in addition to the sternum. Next, let us learn backbone. Look at the picture. This is a backbone. The backbone is a line of bones that runs through the center of our back. It is made up of many small bones called vertebrae. The function of this bone is to support our body's weight as well as to protect the spinal cord. Next, let us learn shoulder bone. Look at the picture. This is a shoulder bone. The shoulder is one of the largest and most complex joints in the body. The shoulder joint is formed where the upper arm bone fits into the shoulder blade like a ball and socket. Next, let us learn pelvic bone. Look at the picture. This is a pelvic bone. The bones which enclose the body part below the stomach are called pelvic bones. What is pelvic bone? The bone which enclose the body part below the stomach are called pelvic bones. Example, hip bone. Next, let us learn the skull. Look at the picture. This is the skull. The skull is made up of many bones joined together. It encloses and protects a very important part of the body, the brain. Next, cartilage. Cartilage is a type of connective tissues found in the body. Cartilage also composes most of the outer ear. Look at the picture. Cartilage also composes most of the outer ear. We discussed many bones and the joints of our skeleton. There are some additional parts of the skeleton that are not as hard as the bones and which can be bent. These are called cartilage. Next, let us learn muscle. Muscle play an important role in the function of the body. Muscles allow a person to move, speak, etc. They control heartbeat, breathing, and digestion. What is a muscle? Look at the picture. The swollen region of the upper arm is a muscle. The muscle bulged due to contraction. Contraction means smaller in length. When contracted, the muscle becomes shorter, stiffer, and thicker. It pulls the bone. Muscles work in pairs. Muscle work in pairs. When one of them contracts, the bone is pulled in that direction. The other muscle of the pair relaxes. One of them contract, the other muscle of the pair relax to move the bone in the opposite direction. The relaxed muscle contracts to pull the bone towards its original position. While the first relaxes, a muscle can only pull, it cannot push. Thus, two muscles have to work together to move a bone. Thank you, dears.